This video was made possible through the support of my patrons. Hey folks, this is Mr. TARDIS. This video is going to be an edited segment of a live stream that I did a couple of nights ago. For those of you who don't know, I've started live streaming every Wednesday night between 7 p.m. and 8:30 p.m. GMT, that's basically UK time. I'm going to be talking about all things Doctor Who from the past week. Things like news, reviews, what's been happening that week in terms of the Doctor Who community, and I'm also bringing on guests every single week. It's kind of like a Mr. TARDIS radio show. We've already had some awesome guests so far in the past few live streams, and a few lined up for the near future that I'm very excited about. So like I said, every Wednesday night, 7 to 8:30 p.m. GMT, this is a segment from the latest live stream. So it's been slightly edited and chopped up a little bit just for the sake of brevity, and also with the actual interview in question. Enjoy the video. Talk about our next topic. We're going to be talking about Doctor Who in charity, because this Saturday it's not children in need, it's Comic Relief, and Doctor Who, that's not a flattering image, but Doctor Who does have a presence at Comic Relief this year. We're going to have Mandip Gill, we're going to have Jodie Whittaker. They're going to be on the set of Casualty. They've done a crossover, Casualty special. Jodie Whittaker and Mandip Gill are there. We also had this interview with Mandip Gill. She's doing... It actually should have already dropped by the time you're watching this. The full interview of Mandip Gill, Gossip and Goddesses with Granny Kumar on Radio 4 and BBC Sound. She did this interview. We might try and talk about this a little bit later. But I just wanted to touch on this really, really quick. I'm conscious that in terms of my schedule, I'm running a little bit behind tonight. But does anyone have like any expectations for what's happening for Comic Relief this weekend? This is basically if John Bishop does join the TARDIS in the first episode of season 13, then this will be the lone Doctor Who story with an all-female TARDIS team. And it's not these two. It's not Dawn French. It is these two. And I like this little teaser image that we got where she is doing her big movement with the screwdriver, and Mandip's like, no, just, you're embarrassing me. So yeah, we are going to be seeing these two at Comic Relief this weekend, which is great. You're going to have Doctor Who as a presence throughout Comic Relief. Also, in terms of Doctor Who alumni, you have Lenny Henry from Spyfall, who is going to be one of the main voices, one of the main hosts of Comic Relief this weekend. And we also have Davina McCall, who's getting involved, who is technically Doctor Who alumni because she was in Bad Wolf. Let's talk about this story from Mandip Gill. She did an interview. Let's just close all of the things and then we'll get you onto the screen. She did an interview recently, Gossip and Goddesses with Granny Kumar. That should be available by the time you're watching or listening to this, on Radio 4 and BBC Sounds, that's the BBC podcast app, saying one day the Doctor will be played by a woman of colour. Gill praises the series for being open and forward-thinking. There's still no official suggestion that Jodie Whittaker will be leaving Doctor Who, but that hasn't stopped the exit rumours from swirling, leading to inevitable speculation about who will play the coveted role in the future. Even Mandip Gill, who plays loyal companion Yaz, has been chatting about who might steer the TARDIS in the years to come. Chatting to Mira Sahil in character as Granny Kumar for her Radio 4 show Gossip and Goddesses with Granny Kumar, Gill says she believes the Doctor will one day be played by a woman of colour.
We love the episode you did all about the partition and the one about Rosa Parks, but was there a deliberate effort to include Black history in the series?
Inside the writers' room, they're very diverse.
Yeah.
You have like Vinay Patel, you had Mallory Blackman on there. Mm, wow. So these ideas, I imagine, were coming through. Mm. But the show has always been a vessel for talking about things like that. I mean, you travel in space and time. It weren't like, oh my God, I can't believe Doctor Who's doing this. It sort of felt like that's what he's supposed to do.
Ah.
Like, them two were my favourite episodes to film.
How conscious do you think you were of little brown girls thinking, if she can do that, I can do that?
Which is exactly what I did watching things like Goodness Gracious Me. Mm. So I am very, very aware there are little people who are watching.
Well, we are all so proud of you, darling.
Thank you.
Definitely. You know, you need to study a little harder now just to make sure you move from a doctor's assistant to doctor, because it will pay you better.
Honestly, Geeta, if Doctor Who was real, all the doctors since Tom Baker would have been Asian, wouldn't they?
Well, frankly, if Doctor Who can change from a man to Jodie Whittaker, going up a few skin tones should be a piece of cake. I mean, do you think we'll ever see a sister playing Doctor Who one day, Mandip?
Yeah, I do. I think there's a long way to go, but there's definitely room for change. And actually, I think at the BBC and at Doctor Who, they are very open and forward-thinking. And so, yeah.
So, yeah, this isn't just, like, baseless speculation. This is just the future of the show and the directions that it might be heading into the future. Personally, I do think that a incarnation of the Doctor will absolutely be a woman of colour in the near future. However, suspenseful sip. I don't think it will be the next one, because, and I'm not saying this is a good thing, I'm not saying that this is a good thing for anyone to be thinking, but have you seen the current UK political climate? The BBC is a public broadcaster. Basically, it's paid for by the taxpayers through the licence fee. Obviously, it has an obligation to those licence fee payers to produce programming that is representative of those paying the licence fee. However, the ones who are currently a hold of the purse, a hold of the pocket, the purse, the wallet, is our current Conservative government, who are vehemently anti-people of colour. Racist, you know, but there's a much less complex term for that that I kind of danced around a bit. And you know that the BBC, if they were going to announce a person of colour or a woman of colour to be the next Doctor, they would want the headlines to be positive. They would not want the immediate backlash and the immediate speculation of woke culture, or the BBC has gone woke, or it's pandering, or it's diversity hiring. I'm not saying that's a good thing. I'm not saying the BBC should cave to those demands, but I think that's the position that they're in. At the very least, I'm confident there's conversations like that happening at the BBC in terms to the future of many of its shows, not just Doctor Who, of course, but Doctor Who is in a unique position where you can break precedent and you directly recast people. You get the straw man accusations of, what about Jane Bond? What about Hannah Solo? And I say they're straw man accusations because they're instances that haven't happened. When people decide to decry diversity casting, it's very apparent that they have no leg to stand on, because they're talking about literally imagined examples. There is no Jane Bond. There is no Hannah Solo. There's very few franchises that could get away with a different casting change like Doctor Who does. Like, for example, if in the next Star Wars movie there was no Han Solo, there was Hannah Solo, obviously I think there'd be a sizable portion of the audience who would be like, great for her, let's respect her life choices and all of that stuff, and, you know, we're massively supportive of you and that's wonderful. But, you know, the Star Wars universe would need some sort of canon explanation, whereas for Doctor Who, it is just regenerate, change your appearance, change your gender, your skin colour, your personality. Everything about you changes. There's an in-universe explanation for that, so it can do it. I think it will happen in the near future. I just don't think it will be the next Doctor. I think it will be a significantly safer pick. I actually have a prediction. I think it's going to be, I'll just get her on screen so you folks know who I'm talking about. I think it's going to be Vicky McClure. That's my current guess. Line of Duty is one of the biggest shows on the BBC. She's an immensely talented performer. She's a proven commodity. She's not an incredibly mainstream pick, like people would throw Oscar nominees and massive Hollywood stars or Chris Marshall into the ring. But she's not a first, like, a massive name, but she's still a big enough proven name with a very good working relationship with the BBC. I think Vicky McClure would be a strong pick. I don't even want to say left field prediction. I don't think that's a particularly controversial pick. I do think the Doctor is going to remain a woman for the foreseeable future. I think the BBC could be in a position where they can have their cake and eat it too, where they could have a female Doctor, a female white Doctor, and also have Jo Martin tagging in and out of the series every so often, a bit like Captain Jack did for the Russell T. Davis era. I think it's the path of least resistance. I think that Mandip Gill is absolutely right, that Doctor Who is a very forward-thinking show. And I also acknowledge that in terms of woke culture and stuff, the battle has kind of more or less been lost in terms of the culture war, in terms of diversity in screen. Like, it happens. You have great representation on screen, or greater in relative terms to how it was a couple of years ago, or a decade ago. You do have more people of colour on screen, more LGBTQ plus people on screen. There's always improvements that can be done. There's always more work to do. Always, absolutely. Never concede the ground. But I do think that when it comes to the BBC, the main work that needs to be done internally is with the news department. I think that's what needs doing. And TARDIS Ollie brings up in the chat, could we actually get a Doctor that doesn't look human? I think maybe, but you also have to remember that the logistics of doing something like that, where they'd need makeup all the time, they'd need constant applications, which can be done sometimes. WandaVision, for example, you've mentioned there, Ollie, is a character who has makeup applied for almost every episode, because sometimes Paul Bettany does take a human form in those stories. It makes sense. I do think that you will get a woman of colour playing the Doctor one day. And I think with Jo Martin, it is kind of a compromise, because she is the Doctor, but she's not the current Doctor. But it's the climate, basically. And I'm not saying that's good. I'm not saying I support it. You need to read the room. And there are people at the BBC who will get paid to read the room. They will have the spreadsheets. They will have the stats. They will have the polls. It's their duties to do it. Anyway, that's just my thoughts on that story.